5 seconds. My dear friends, I am very happy to be here today with you for the inauguration of this first annual conference of Chief Secretaries of State Governments. I greet and welcome each one of you. I hope that in the time to come, this annual conference will become a forum for useful and productive exchange of views between the center and the states. I thank the Cabinet Secretary for taking steps for proposing this conference. We are meeting at the beginning of a new decade. Economic reforms over the last 20 years have enabled us to become one of the speedy growing economies in the world. Not only this, we have also the power to deal and meet the challenge of crisis. We are now more capable than ever before in fighting poverty, hunger, and disease and providing a better quality of life to our people. We also now live in an environment where the Indian economy is increasingly getting integrated with the international economy, and Indian talent and enterprise is recognized by all over the world. You hold an important position in the state administration. It is your duty to ensure that the administrative machinery is geared to match the challenges. I expect that the discussions in this conference will give you a better appreciation of the background in which the central government takes policy decisions. I also expect that will help you to find ways of responding in tackling problems which involve more than one state. I hope that this will enable you to offer a more considered advice to your own government. You are all aware that inclusive growth is the most important factor for our development process. Fast economic growth has little meaning if it does not lead to the well-being of our poor farmers, workers, our children, students, and women. The benefits of the development process have to reach to every part of our country and to every section of our society if we want to progress in the true sense of the term and be a strong nation. The central government has attached the highest importance to our growth being inclusive in nature. But India lives in states. Unless and until the states move forward at a pace that is adequate to the challenges that we face, I think we cannot claim that we have delivered inclusive growth. The inclusive growth that we talk about is reflected in the schemes like the National Rural Employment Program, the National Rural Health Mission, the new 15-point program for the welfare of the minorities, and other programs designed to improve the quality of social and economic infrastructure. All these programs require the active participation and commitment of the state governments. It falls upon you to ensure that these programs are implemented in the spirit in which they have been conceived. There is every need for improving the local body institutions as a means for an effective decentralized planning system for inclusive growth. All this constitutes a great task that requires dedication and commitment. I would like to say that there is always room for improvement in these schemes and programs. Planning from below is as important as thinking of the needs of the nation as a whole. We would welcome any suggestions regarding the design and implementation of the programs. I would like to say that there are problems which require a response which is coordinated not only between the affected states but also between the center and the states. This requires that our response to problems should be more creative than ever before. From the Secretary General, Lok Sabha Secretariat, to all the presiding officers and the secretaries of state legislative assemblies. Dear sirs, in continuation of this office letter of even number dated 14th July 2011, I am delighted to inform you that 71st All India Presiding Officers Conference will be held at Jaipur for 5 days in the next month. The main agenda of the conference would be on strengthening constitutional scheme of checks and balances, the role of the legislature in scrutinizing and making laws of good governance, and the importance of question hour and the steps to be taken to safeguard the question hour. This subject is particularly chosen in view of the frequent disturbance of question hour in the legislative bodies. Background note on this subject is being prepared and will be circulated separately. Detailed program will be sent to you in due course. Therefore, your presence is very essential in this meeting. You will be treated as state guests and provided with accommodation and other facilities. You can be accompanied by your spouse and private secretary. The notes on the subjects to be discussed in the conference will be sent to you separately. You are therefore requested to kindly to communicate to this office urgently the order of preference of subjects on which presiding officers of your legislatures would like to speak. Kindly acknowledge receipt of this letter by way of sending fax. Yours faithfully.